My solids look a little bit leaning tower of pizza. Greetings all and welcome to Dave's Craft Room. And on today's video, I have this gorgeous stack of solids that we're gonna use today in our math quilt. We're gonna make a quilt that has to do with math. Technically speaking, all quilts have math in them. I always act like I'm terrible at math, and yet I do it all the time. So let me explain. Ages ago, I saw this chart on Reddit. Somebody posted it and said, "When does make a gorgeous quilt?" I can no longer find the post. Sorry for that. So we're gonna make it, we're gonna make a quilt. This would actually be the perfect time to use the thinking cap. However, all of the answers already came to me in the shower. Let me explain this chart. I have it over here, but you'll see it on the screen. Every prime number is a color. When you see a whole solid square, that means that number is prime. So for example, 2 is blue, 3 is red, those are primes. And then 4 is 2 times 2. So we see 2 chunks of blue. 6 is blue times red, or which is to say 2 times 3. And then if we go to a weird number like 96, we can see that 96 is 2 times 2 is 4, times 2 is 8, times 2 is 16, times 2 is 32, and then times red times 3 is 96. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna pull a color for each prime number. I'm gonna try to match it to the chart just so that my brain doesn't get confused. I could change it if I wanted to, but I'll probably stick to the chart as it is for the most part. Pull them, make blocks out of those because that'll be the easiest thing to start with. And then sew patchwork blocks for the rest of them. These are the things, these are the parameters that came to me in the shower. For the labels, I wanna have each block labeled with a number. So I have loads of these 2.5-inch white strips. Those will end up being 2 inches when we sew them in. I'll sew them to the bottom and I'm going to embroider the number on it. I'll trace a font that I find, on the computer. I'll just put that on the iPad and trace it, probably with this. This is washable, and do that. And then when we have numbers like, for example, 32 is 2 times 2 times 2 times 2 times 2. That's just a blue square with black thin lines between it. I think the thing to do is I'm gonna get very thin black bias tape, 1/4 inch black bias tape, and use that to divide up a single blue thing. That'll be the easiest way. You could piece it, but if I piece it, that's not gonna show very clearly the division that this is 2 times 2. You know, from just a short distance away, it's gonna look solid. And then to piece a black line, and that would add a million extra steps. I think this is gonna be the thing to do. So what I need, first of all, is to do some math and pull some fabric. What are prime numbers? Okay, so 2. We have the most of 2. Every even number is gonna have 2. So let me find some blue. Oh, I have some red here. Stunning. It's number 3. Bought yellow fabric ages ago, but I can't find it in my craft room. What am I gonna do? All right, so I've pulled all my fabric. White. I need white, just kidding. I've now put all my fabric and what I need to do. So let's see, I said 2 6-inch squares, which will end up being 6 by 8 inches when we have the labels on each number on. So let's start with cutting 106 inch by 2.5. These are already 2.5-inch strips. I cut them for something else and had too many. Start with that. I'm going to use blue and red the most, so I start by cutting long strips of those colors in the width I need, and then I proceed one by one all the way up to 100. It was easy to divide the 6-inch block into sections of 2, 3, or 4 because those numbers go easily into 6. If I needed 4 sections, I knew each section needed to be 1.5 inches.
So then I added a quarter of an inch seam allowance to either side and cut 2-inch strips. I did similar math for all the blocks. It was a little tricky when I had to divide the 6-inch block into 5 sections, but I just tried my best to cut even sections. I also sewed black sashing to the sides of the blocks. I used bias tape as well, which I made from 1/2-inch wide black fabric strips. I used the ruler to draw lines on the block where the bias tape needed to go, and then I basted it on with washable glue stick and top stitched it down with black thread. There are a lot of interesting patterns on this chart, such as all the even numbers with blue in them create vertical lines on every other column, just like the multiples of 5 in yellow in the middle and on the right side. Multiples of 3 create red diagonals across it, as well as a hot pink diagonal line of multiples of 11. I like this chart and this quilt because you don't need any language to understand it, and I think that when the aliens come to Earth, if they're not here already, they would also be able to understand it.
This is wrong. I'm gonna have to fix this one later. The blue is meant to be on the left. I will fix it later.
This is how I embroidered the letters on. It's just a straight black line with black thread, and I used the straight stitch foot first, but then I switched to the free motion foot and it worked a lot better. The original chart had number 1 in the bottom left and 100 in the top right, and I decided that I preferred to start with number 1 in the upper left side, just like the way I would write the numbers on a sheet of paper. I preferred doing it that way, and it still preserves all the patterns that I previously described. So this is the final result. It came out exactly the way I pictured, and I really enjoyed making this 100 block prime number factorization chart math quilt. If you enjoyed this video, say so in the comments, and please like and subscribe to my channel. Thank you for coming to Dave's Craft Room, and please come again.